Great save by number 30, Jack Dobbs. Welcome back to the Mizzou Club Hockey live stream between Missouri Tigers and the Arkansas Razorbacks, who are coming into town from Fayetteville. We apologize for the delay in getting up and getting situated here. I got a computer on my lap, so a little bit of a finicky setup as we speak, holding the phone with one hand. Tonight is senior night here at Washington Park in Jefferson City, Missouri. Pre-game honorees include Cole Gast, Clayton Lieberman, and Brad Erlewine, the three senior Tigers on this club hockey team, as well as team manager Grace Rodriguez. The Tigers dump it on down. Puck will go out of play for our first stoppage here. I apologize. I believe that was the second. 13:47 remaining in the first period. be thankful for those face guards. I think that was Jack Hazleton who just got popped in the face with a puck. Tigers' defensive integrity being tested early. So far, so good as Arkansas really maintaining hold of the puck often in the attacking zone. Washington Park. We've got fans in all sections of the bleachers. Yeah. 8:03 remaining. Apologies for not changing the clock on the scoreboard. certainly one of the faster first periods I've seen here. Only a handful of stoppages. No penalties yet. We just had some fluid hockey. This is Dobbs carries that one offside. Nice save off the deflection. It's the Tigers lose possession, but great recovery. Save from Dobbs as that one gets fired in. And a whistle from the referee. They might get the Tigers for a penalty, and they do. So Austin Gass is going to go into the box for the first penalty of the night. Arkansas gets the scoring started with a power play goal. Fired a shot in off Dobbs. And it was Jake Schaefer who cleaned it up for the Hogs right out in front of the net. And with 6:22 remaining, Arkansas has their first lead of the game. Tigers will look to bounce back. Jones to draw the ice. Off a deflection. And a whistle at that, even though it stays inside the rink. Thank you. unbelievable glove save from Jack Dobbs. That one was too quick for me to follow. But man, the reflexes on that kid. Something special. Dobbs has faced a handful of shots on net already. You got to give credit to a tough Arkansas team. Their last series was against Kansas, where I believe they picked up a two-game sweep. But before that, they took on a North Texas team that split with Mizzou. As the Tigers have a chance in front of the net. That goes awry. Mizzou still possesses, but now Arkansas gets away. But Arkansas's series against North Texas, as a chance goes just wide, against North Texas, resulted in the Hogs 17-1 win. 17-1. Quite the scoreline from that one. Mizzou took on NT in Texas. I believe it's in Denton, if I'm not mistaken. And I believe won the opening game of that series and lost the second. This is a matchup against two of the more solid teams in the ACHA Division III ranks. Tigers are going to get a line change here, excuse me. 3:23 and counting in this first period. Apologies, just realized that scoreboard wasn't updated. Should be good. For those of you who may have joined our broadcast after that first goal was scored, it was a power play goal scored by Jake Schaefer of the Razorbacks. With about 6.5 minutes remaining in this first period, currently 1:48 and counting. Shot in front. Tigers still in this one. And now the Tigers with a 2-on-1 breakaway. the backhander stopped. Missouri threatening these last couple of minutes to draw it even, but that goes for both sides. As Arkansas is trying to extend their lead, a couple of great chances there. As we're under the final minute in this first period. Arkansas makes it 2-0. So that'll do it for the first period. Arkansas with the early 2-0 lead in the first period. Goals coming for number 15, Jake Schaefer. Number 17, Zach Wilson for Arkansas. But Jack Dobbs still putting in a shift as the Tigers try to regather ahead of the second period. We'll be back with more hockey action in about 15 minutes. Stay with us. Series of physical exchanges. It's going to call for a stoppage by the referees. That third goal was scored by number 9, Griffin Sugasaway for the Razorbacks. Correction, it was number 15, Jake Scherer, who scored that first power play goal for the Arkansas Razorbacks in the first period. So Arkansas leads 3-0. Got the officials discussing some things with the Arkansas bench.
Thank you.
What a start to this second period for the Arkansas Razorbacks, who take a 4-0 lead. Behind the goal for number 43, Jacob Howerman. Who puts it in net for the Tigers. We still trail 4-1, but anything to help that deficit as they fight back in this one. Jacob Kasten's shot forces a save out of the Razorback goalkeeper, Josef Tisenka. Tisenka hasn't seen much action, but now the Tigers starting to put some puck on net. 14:31 remaining here in the second period. Fired from long range at Dobbs, who easily gloves it. Currently on the ice right now, we've got number 19, Kyle Jahala. I believe I saw number 24, Drew Driscoll. Ethan Eplin, number 11, also there. That puck goes out of play. Tigers are going to go with a full line change. Number 7, Cole Gass. Number 14, Andrew Kruska. Brett Martin. Trevor Jones. And I believe Andrew Cacioppo as well on the ice for the Tigers. Cacioppo down in the corner. He'll lose the puck after the hit. Dumped on in behind the cage. Arkansas possesses. Good fight along the boards from the Tigers. were pushed back into their defensive zone but regained the puck. Race in the corner. Won by the Arkansas defender. It's number 29, Sam Haynes. Or excuse me, Chris Yonts. That puck was lost behind the cage as we get a whistle. So what's gonna be a face-off for the Tigers in the attacking zone? 12:14 remaining here at Mizzou Ice Hockey Arena in Washington Park. Didn't look to be far away. I think Dobbs ended up saving it. 12 minutes remaining here in the second period. Tigers donning these new uniforms for the first time tonight. Just to make things difficult, they had to switch up the numbers on me, which is why I'm a little slow right now and figuring out who's who. Chance on net saved by Dobbs. 11:27 remaining. Let's update that one on the scoreboard for you. Save as a little scuffle occurs in front of the cage. Tigers win the faceoff. So Desanka gloves that shot from Estes. 10:22 remaining here in the second period as we're about halfway through action. Arkansas wins the faceoff. And advance the puck as there's some action in front of the crease. to see what's going on in the corner. Some faces in the way. As that one was whistled dead by the referees, and I think it's going to be a penalty going against the Tigers. Potentially a boarding call against number 24, Drew Driscoll. Will be forced to take a seat on the bench in the box. As Missouri is a man down for 2 minutes. With 9:27 remaining in this half, or in this period, excuse me. Tigers with a kill. 30 seconds elapsed off this power play. Saw their second of the night. Number 25, Cameron McAfee, is the one who put that one away for the Razorbacks, who now take a 5-1 lead. Here at Washington Park. Down the ice come the Hawks to force the save by Dobbs. Dobbs with yet another save. Thank you. just a breakaway chance for the Tigers. Nice play from Desanka to come out of the zone and go halfway into the circle, it looked like, to throw that one out of the danger. I think it was number 12, Jack Chubb, chasing after that puck. No damage to the Tigers as they take the faceoff in their own zone, and Arkansas with a breakaway. And that one's off the post. Chahala rattled that one off iron. As the Tigers are still showing fight. Tigers unable to keep it in the attacking zone, and it'll be a faceoff right outside the blue line. Minutes remaining here in the second period. Icing goes against the Tigers. Play by number 34, Jack Estes, to win that puck in the center zone and advance it. The Tigers aren't able to take advantage of the turnover, but it earns them a faceoff in the attacking zone. Razorbacks. Baby, great team play. Leading up to the goal by number 89, Brad Estrada. So Arkansas, with under 3 minutes to go here in this second period, has a 6-1 lead over the Tigers. Second period. Razorbacks off the rebound. 7-1. Forgive me, I don't believe that number 52's name was on the roster that I was given pre-game, but it's Cruz who scores the goal for Arkansas. The sixth individual goal scorer, all seven of the Razorbacks' goals have come from different players. Five in this second period. So they jump out to a big lead. As 30 seconds remain here in this second period, one that the Tigers are going to want to put behind them. Now, Missouri hasn't faced a deficit this large through two since the game on Friday night against Maryville, which was an away game in St. Louis. The first of a two-game series. Mizzou ended up dropping that game 10-1. Just 1 second left on the clock here in the second period, so this is just going to be a puck drop and horn. And a rough second period for the Tigers. They got a goal from Jack Estes to narrow what was a 4-0 lead to 4-1. But then the Hogs score three straight, forcing the Tigers to enter the locker room with a 7-1 deficit. We'll be back with the third period in about 15 minutes. Welcome back. We've got third period action between the Tigers and the Hogs. And Arkansas went on a tear in the second period, scoring 5 goals, all coming from different players. Recap of that second period for you. First off, it was Griffin Sagasaway. I'm not going to get that pronunciation right. I apologize to the chat. Chance in front for the Tigers, and it's a goal! The quick start that the Tigers needed here in this third and final period. And it's going to be number 10, Henry Kasten, who puts it away to make this a 2-7 game as the Tigers try to claw back. Not a minute has gone down here in that third period, and the Tigers already find themselves in the back of the net. So that first line for the Tigers will come off the ice. Tigers will get a stoppage in play. And as I was saying before that last goal, it was Sagasaway and then Jacob Howerman who scored to make it 4-0. Tigers responded with a goal from Jack Estes. But then Arkansas scored 3 previously unanswered goals to wrap up that second period. First it was Cameron McAfee, then Brad Estrada, and then it was Kyle Cruz, number 52, who scored the final one with under a minute left in that second period. But it's Henry Kasten who makes it 7-2. Solid hit for number 11, Ethan Epland. Arkansas brings it forward. Shot saved off the pad of Dobbs. Chasing out is Brett Martin. And now it's Cole Gass with the puck who advances it into the attacking zone. Solid defense from Arkansas to jar loose possession. Battle for the puck. One by Mizzou. Backhander. Puck still in front. Can't get that second shot away. Tigers had a great chance on net. And they're showing some energy here in this third period. That one goes behind the blue line. Nice skating by Trevor Jones. Goes into the left corner. My apologies, my phone cord is just not long enough, so we're getting a little bit of rail in our view. I brought a 10-foot one. I know this is kind of random. We're in the middle of a hockey game. Brought a 10-foot one, but the connectivity on it, for whatever reason, isn't working. As that's a breakaway chance for Trevor Jones. Save! Puck in front! But moved aside. Tigers with another great chance here early in the third period. That puck goes behind the net. Tigers wanted it nice. They didn't get it. One back by Mizzou as they move it ahead. Big hit. Big hit delivered at the center of the ice. But the pass still got through to number 3, Jack Goddard, who had a one-on-one chance with Josef Desanka. But Desanka makes the stop. Ladies and gentlemen, I am an idiot. I think I have been screaming on black this whole time. Goodness me. Nothing shows up. Just a moment. Apologies to all the viewers out there. We had some technical difficulties that I just was not aware of. Stream should be good now. That goal from the Tigers was scored by number 10, Henry Caskin. As I was talking on top of black. But a solid start from these Tigers in this third period. Tiger fan base banging on the glass. So the officials are still trying to sort out what happened. We even have an official on the ice. That was Corey Reese, number 22, came off the ice to the bench without his helmet. So the officials are going to discuss what will certainly be at least one penalty assessment. I'm sure more than one as well. In the meantime, it's a good time to adjust our timing. 13:42 left in this matchup. Here in the third period. So the referee discussing the changes with Henry Caskin and Zach Wilson of the Razorbacks. I don't know if I could ever go without. long stoppage of play. That's Andrew Krusko, who just entered that penalty box. Empty on the Razorback side. We'll see if anyone hops in shortly. That's Jacob Yassine, who will serve some time for the Razorbacks. Potential. I don't see Krusko in the box anymore either. But we do have some penalties on the board. A double minor and a major assessed. I believe that Krusko may have been ejected. It'll be Jack Chubb in the box for the Tigers, but I believe the major was assessed against Andrew Krusko. So we're 4-on-4 here at Washington Park for the next four. And then Arkansas is going to get a man advantage for another minute. Nice center. Into the slot. Save made by Dobbs. Was forced to get big in front of the crease. Tigers on the other end. That shot. Saved in front and cleared away. Estes with the wrister. And behind a goal! Tigers blowing it back. And his second goal in the third period. It's number 10, Henry Caston, who follows up that shot from Estes. So that deficit now just 4 goals for the Tigers, who make it a 7-3 ball game with 12:23 remaining. Arkansas at the other end. Pass along the point. Excuse me, along the blue line, point to point. Is Mizzou moving it forward? That one sails wide and into the netting. So we'll get a stoppage as Mizzou continuing to put up a fight. May have hit off of the helmet of Dobbs. That took a weird bounce. Another great chance for the Tigers. Sean Carrier, number 22, delivering that hit against the boards. Some great skating by number 17, Miles Morris, to catalyze that attack. But Mizzou unable to capitalize. and they'll regroup with 11 minutes remaining here in this third period. Arkansas pressuring number six, Clayton Lieberman, along the boards. And they'll win it back. As their attack becomes a slow prod, that one gets out of the attacking zone. But Arkansas brings it right back in. Oh, great move. Shot. And a goal. Cameron McAfee with his second of the night. Believe it went through the five hole. And Mizzou putting up a fight to get back in it. And Arkansas responds. Eight to three Razorbacks. In a high-scoring affair at Washington Park, Ice Arena. So the Tigers may need something special to pull this one back in their favor. But they've been pressing here in this third period. Jacob Kasten's pass to Essis goes into the corner. And that one's going to hit the ceiling and cause a stoppage in play. And Coach Teeter has been playing with the lines a little bit this season. And right now, this top line of the Kasten brothers, Henry and Jacob and Jack Essis, has certainly been the most effective tonight for the Tigers. Credited with all three of their goals thus far. All three of them playing with a lot of good pace. Good stick, I believe that was from Jacob Kasten. As Arkansas entered the attacking zone, pushed right back out and forced to dump it on down and give the puck back to the Tigers. There's Morris showing off some of that speed. The Mizzou can't hang on to it. And it goes in behind. And from the Tigers, big hit delivered on Henry Kasten. But he gets right back up. Into the corner, up to the point, slap. That's going to hit the backboards, but kept in. The icing call going against Arkansas. Tigers get a new set of skaters on the ice. Ethan Eplin, Drew Driscoll, Andrew Cachopo on the ice for Mizzou. Here's Eplin handing it off to Brett Martin, also Logan Conroy, rounding out the five for Missouri. We're back to 5-on-5 hockey. That one goes on down behind the red line for another icing call. Once again, I apologize for the technical difficulties. Missing that first goal of the third period. The second goal for the Tigers, scored by Henry Kasten. Thankfully, got another one on camera, so he didn't come up empty. as Arkansas on the break. Center. Goes past the attack. Mizzou throws it away. Out of danger. Mizzou with the line change. Austin Gass. Sean Carrier. Jack Chubb on the ice, number 12. Trevor Jones. And Jack Goddard, currently on the ice for the Tigers. As that clock slowly prods on down, and the Tigers running out of time to complete this comeback. Good defending from Trevor Jones to get rid of that one. And the Tigers, you know, playing a little shorthanded tonight. Colin Jones still out after, I believe, what was an ankle injury, lower leg injury, that he picked up earlier in the season, I believe, against Maryville. And also out of tonight's game as that puck once again hits up top and will cause a stoppage. Number 9, Mizzou's captain, Holden Carroll, also missing tonight's game with an illness. Unsure of his availability for tomorrow night's game. But he's a guy that the Tigers would love to have on the ice, the president of this club hockey team for Missouri. Big hit. Delivered by Drew Driscoll. Fantastic skating by, I believe, Estes. But he couldn't get the backhander toward the net. Arkansas controlling the puck and advancing into center ice and into the attacking zone. Big hit. As Arkansas puts another one in the back of the net, it's a hat trick for McAfee. Upper 90. Beats Dobbs on his stick side. As Arkansas goes ahead 9-3. And that might just about do it. Unless the Tigers can find a way to score more than a goal a minute in these final 4 minutes and 35 seconds. Got to hand it to these Razorbacks. They have performed tonight at a high level. All 3 periods, multiple goals. Just been relentless in their pressure. Have held a lot of the possession tonight. And really kept the Tigers out of the attacking zone for a lot of chances. And to be fair, the Tigers have been pretty clinical with those chances tonight. But they found themselves in some tough sledding. Brad Erlewine seeing some game time. Why you always in the mood? traps another. So we've got exactly 4 minutes remaining here. In this final period. Goal for the Razorbacks. I believe it's McAfee with his fourth goal of the night. You know, we were talking about how it was coming from a lot of different guys, but an absolute explosion for McAfee here in this third period. As the Razorbacks really laying it on late. And a 3 lead for Arkansas. Logan Conroy found himself one-on-one. What a great save from Joseph Desanka. Desanka's been playing pretty well tonight, you know. He's been an aggressive keeper for sure. Good stick by Desanka to clear that one aside. With a shot and a goal! The late wrister for number 44, Logan Conroy. Great shot from Conroy to bag his first goal of the night inside the 2 minute remaining mark. Potentially a little bit too late in terms of a comeback effort, but impressive shot from the Tiger winger, who does a little bit of everything for this team. Physical player, can really affect the game at both ends. And his name's been on the score sheet quite a bit this season. His father, a frequenter of many games here at Washington Park, makes the trek all the way out from St. Louis. And Arkansas just is not easing up here late. But neither are the Tigers. Nice move
Is that puck still loose?
What a dangle from Austin Gass to clear himself one-on-one with Desanka. But he's unable to finish as Teeter makes another line change. But great skating from the Tigers. As this yellow line featuring the Kasten brothers and Jack Estes comes back onto the ice. They've got Driscoll and Hazelton to back him up in defense. Just taking off his skates. Referee's just going to let it play. Because we're under 10 seconds here for game one between the Arkansas Razorbacks and the Missouri Tigers. As the Hogs victorious in game one of two. 10-4 the final. And it was a great effort from a lot of different guys on that Razorback team, but none more than Cameron McAfee, who comes away with four goals, three in this third period to take it as the Tigers falter on senior night. But they'll look to even up the series tomorrow night as action kicks off at around 6 p.m. Central Time. Tigers dropped to 7-6 on the season. Goal scorers, Henry Kasten twice. Jack Estes, the first goal for the Tigers. And then a late one from Logan Conroy. But that'll do it here from Washington Park. We appreciate you guys for tuning in. We'll have coverage of tomorrow night's game right here on this YouTube channel. And we wish you a wonderful rest of your night.